I am in the Los Angeles area for the next few weeks, and I have been looking for things to do as things are slowly starting to open up. One of the places I found is the Heritage Square Museum. This is a museum that explores the first 100 years of California statehood, but I think it focuses mostly on the late 19th and early 20th century. There are 8 Victorian homes built during the Victorian era that were saved from demolition and are on display here. Now, because things are partially shut down, we can't go into any of these homes today, but it is an outdoor self-guided tour. So I've never been here before and I'm really looking forward to it. So let's get in and see what's happening. Heritage Square is just east of downtown Los Angeles along the Arroyo Seco in Lincoln Heights. It is at the end of a very narrow two-way street. This is my yellow beetle. Los Angeles has been a city since 1781, but they experienced a real economic and industrial boom in the late 1800s that resulted in a lot of these beautiful Victorian houses. But as time goes on, the old is torn down in favor of new, more modern buildings. In the 1960s, these amazing homes were being torn down almost daily in order to make room for condos, apartment buildings, office buildings, and so on. So a group of prominent citizens formed the Cultural Heritage Foundation of Southern California to try to save some of these homes and relocate them to a permanent location. So far, they have been able to save and restore 8 of these historically significant homes. This is the Palms Depot. You check in at the Palms Depot, which also serves as a general store when it's open. As the name suggests, it was a railroad depot, and when you know that, it kind of makes sense why this boxcar is sitting out in the middle of all of these Victorian homes. This depot was located about halfway between downtown Los Angeles and Santa Monica. It was built in 1887 in what's known as the Eastlake style. It was in operation until 1953, and after that, it was kind of abandoned and fell into disrepair. It was rescued and brought to the Heritage Square in 1975. This is the Perry House. This gorgeous white house is also called the Mount Pleasant House. Was built in 1876 for lumber baron William Hayes Perry. This was once the largest house in Los Angeles, and it is now the largest house in Heritage Square. The architecture is Greek Revivalist Italianate. It was originally located on Pleasant Avenue in Boyle Heights, and it was brought to Heritage Square in 1975. I really like this house. I love the front porch. I love all the details, but I wish they would paint some of these details a different color other than the white. I think the white on everything makes it lose some of the beauty of those details. This house is the Hale House. Now, this was built sometime between 1887 and 1888, and it had multiple owners, and it was in 2 different locations before it was brought to Heritage Square in 1970. But look at all of the details on this house. This architecture is a combination of Queen Anne and Eastlake. The colors on the outside were reproduced from the original colors that were found during the restoration. This is probably my favorite house here. It's got a lot going on, but I love this house. Behind me is the Valley Knudson Garden Residence. Now, this home was built in 1883 to 1884, and like the Hale House, it had multiple previous owners, and it was on 2 different locations before it ended up at Heritage Square. Now, notice the roofline on this house. It was first designed by French architect N.F. Mansart. Napoleon II used this design to create a uniform vista along the boulevards in Paris. The house also has some Queen Anne detailing. These doves and lilies are Christian symbols, which is pretty common to put into architecture in that time period. Valley Knudson was married to Thomas Knudson of Knudson Ice Cream. Now, she never lived in this house, but she did a lot of charitable work, and one of her organizations paid for a good portion of the renovation of this house after it was brought to Heritage Square in 1970. So in honor of everything she did, they named the house after her. This is the carriage barn. This cute little barn was built in 1899 on the grounds where Huntington Memorial Hospital is today. It would house two horses and one carriage for a doctor who worked there. It is a Carpenter Gothic architectural style, and today it serves as a garage, a maintenance and storage facility. This is the John J. Ford House. John J. Ford was a prolific wood carver whose work can be seen in the California State Capitol and the Iolani Palace in Hawaii. This house was built in 1888, and he lived here with his wife and five children. The house features his wood carvings both inside and out. Unfortunately, everything is closed inside, so we can only see the outside. The architecture is a combination of Eastlake, Queen Anne, and Italianate. This house is the Longfellow-Hastings. Hold on. I got it now. This house is the Longfellow-Hastings Octagon House. The idea for an octagon house came from Orson S. Fowler, who pointed out that eight sides would give a house a lot of light and a lot of air circulating through the house. Gilbert Longfellow built his first octagon house based on these concepts on the East Coast, but after his wife and child died from tuberculosis, he moved the rest of his family here to California, and he built this octagon house in Pasadena in 1893. It was saved from destruction in 1986 and moved to Heritage Square. This is the only substantially unaltered Victorian era octagon house in California. That is a mouthful. This is the Lincoln Avenue Methodist Church. This church was built in 1897. It was designed by George W. Cramer, who designed more than 2,000 Methodist churches worldwide. The architecture for this building combines Carpenter Gothic, Queen Anne, and neoclassical elements. They're still renovating the interior, but it is called the Akron-style floor plan, which incidentally looks exactly like the floor plan from the church I grew up in Kentucky. This church was moved to Heritage Square in 1981. This is the Colonial Drugstore. The lights are on inside. There's no yellow tape, so it might be open. I'm going to go in and check it out. This isn't the original building, but a recreation of the original Colonial Drugstore, which operated in Highland Park, just 1 mile from Heritage Square. The family that owned the original Colonial Drugs generously donated the original fixtures, a vintage soda fountain, and a unique collection of drug products from the period to give the drugstore its authentic feel. Even though you can't go into any of these houses right now, this is still a really interesting park to come to. These houses are fantastic, and they're just all so different and of the same era. If you'd like to hear more about Los Angeles history, check out my video on Alvarez Street, which is the oldest street in Los Angeles. If you're interested in a little bit of San Francisco history, check out my series on Chinatown. Thank you for watching.